there are 20 confirmed cases of the novel coronavirus in the Philippines.
The Department of Health reported 10 new confirmed cases of the coronavirus disease 2019 or COVID-19 on top of the 4 new cases announced yesterday, March 8, 2020. This brings the total number of confirmed cases in the country to 20.
The DOH says it will only test patients already showing respiratory symptoms, travel to countries with recorded cases, or exposed to those who tested positive. President Rodrigo Duterte also declares a state of public health emergency on Monday, March 9. Duterte's declaration is based on the recommendation of Health Secretary Francisco Duque III, who earlier raised the Philippines' coronavirus alert system to code red, sublevel 1, due to the first case of local transmission. The Presidential Security Group also announces it will be implementing a no-touch policy between Duterte and the public. Anybody who goes near the president needs to be screened. Local governments in Metro Manila also announced precautions being taken to prevent the spread of the virus. Pasig City Mayor Vico Soto says public events and gatherings in Pasig City are cancelled and all permit requests for large private events are on hold. Makati Mayor Abby Binay confirms a Taiwanese man who tested positive for the coronavirus visited Makati City and orders the city's task force to make sure all residents follow precautionary measures. Quezon City Mayor Joy Belmonte says among the coronavirus patients is a 57-year-old male from the First District. The patient had visitors from China, the US, and Davao since December 2019. Family members of the patient are put on self-quarantine for 14 days. The spread of the novel coronavirus pushes Philippine shares off a cliff. The Philippine Stock Exchange Index on Monday plunges 6.8% and closes at 6,312.61, suffering its steepest one-day percentage drop since the 2008 global financial crisis. The government's economic team also says it is likely to miss economic growth target in 2020 due to the virus. The Commission on Elections, or COMELEC, also suspends voter registration starting Tuesday, March 10, until the end of the month. Even long-running noontime variety show It Bulaga says it will temporarily suspend the admission of a live studio audience. Countries have also started issuing travel bans on the Philippines, such as Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, Qatar, and the Cook Islands. The Foreign Affairs Department also says two Filipinos tested positive for 2019 nCoV in Lebanon, increasing the total number of Filipinos who caught the virus outside the Philippines to 91. Philippine senators asked the Supreme Court to compel President Rodrigo Duterte to seek the Senate's concurrence in terminating the Visiting Forces Agreement. Senator Richard Gordon says this issue should clarify where the President's powers end.
I'm sure my colleagues here will agree na dapat talaga, there cannot be absolutism in our government. We are a democracy. There are three branches of government that must coalesce with one another.
Senate President Tito Soto, a Duterte ally, tries to soften the blow by saying it's not an affront to Duterte. By asking the justices to compel Malacanang to seek their buy-in, the petition effectively challenges the wisdom and decision of the president. This marks the first time senators of the majority bloc are challenging a policy of the Duterte administration before the Supreme Court. But Duterte's fiercest allies in the Senate, Senators Ronald De La Rosa and Bongo, did not sign the resolution that paved the way for the petition. Malacanang defends President Rodrigo Duterte's decision to neither ban nor suspend Philippine offshore gaming operations, despite their supposed crime links, saying problems associated with the industry are commonplace.
I don't know how he consults, but the president, when he makes a decision, it's a decisive one and he has a basis to support his decision. Problema ka, pinagpipilitin nyo na yung Pogo, eh masama. Eh hindi naman masama. Ang masama, yung mga nag-ooperate na iba. O edi yun ang tigilin natin, i-prosecute natin.
Panelo adds, Duterte says revenues gained from the industry are needed to fund various government projects. Panelo also says apart from taxes, there are not enough sources of funds for government projects. At several Senate hearings, senators find that POGOs are linked to crimes including sex trafficking, drug trafficking, corruption, kidnap for ransom, money laundering, and the forgery of documents, among others. It was also revealed in a Senate hearing that POGOs routinely bribe immigration officials to fast-track the entry of Chinese workers. Facebook is shutting down its London office and part of its Singapore base for deep cleaning after an employee was diagnosed with coronavirus. A staff member working at the Marina One office in Singapore was diagnosed with COVID-19 on Friday. The infected employee also visited Facebook's London offices between February 24 and 26. Facebook already closed its Shanghai office until further notice, while employees in Italy and South Korea are encouraged to work from home. Staff in the San Francisco Bay Area have also been strongly encouraged to work from home starting Friday.